Righty ho, we are back again, ladies and gentlemen. Game number two here of this two-game series between 99% and London Conspiracy, as the draft, you can see, has begun. And it's going to be a completely different game to the one we just saw. Death Prophet, Venge, Lone Druid, Witch Doctor, what are these new heroes? It's magical. It's amazing. There's no Invoker. There's, for now, no Juggernaut. And no Sven to be seen of as we get through to the second ban phase. And I can welcome in my co-caster, Ryu. This is panning out to be something completely different. Radiant
team ban. There's still a Venge in the game. It's not completely different. No,
I've never seen Venge before in my life.
I mean, that would be pretty cool, though, if you think about it. Just one day, mix up all of the hero abilities, all 100 heroes. I would have to take at least a week to understand everything once again, at least. And that would be me playing for like 12 hours a day. If you mixed up all the spells, and it'd basically be like League of Legends or something, just learning a new game, but not as easy. Definitely more difficult here. And, well, DP, Venge, Lone Druid, and Witch Doctor, like you said, these heroes, Witch Doctor plus Lone Druid. Obviously, Witch Doctor is a great counter for the Lone Druid, but they grabbed it up, maybe anticipating that. Against the DP and the Venge, it definitely can help out a lot to when you cast the Death Ward, and then you can get a lot of the physical DPS in. And then I always see the Paralyzing Cast do a lot of work. It's very underrated as a single target stun because it has so many chances to bounce around. I think it's even better than just a Lich ulti. When I see Lich, I don't see any of the ultis hitting. They never really bounce that much, maybe one or two times. But Witch Doctor, obviously, you have that mini stun, so it gives you that extra. Oh, that'd be a cool buff for Lich. You know, you bounce. If it bounces to a target, you get a 1 second stun or something. Oh, there we go. I found the buff I swagged.
Perfectly balanced. Perfectly balanced. Ryu is now our Lord and Savior, OS Frog himself, balancing spells by adding stuns to them. Well, let's just add stun to everything. Like Blade Fury stuns people when you spin on them.
That would be pretty cool, though.
Mm-hmm. Death Ward.
And then just add backtrack on every hero.
Death Ward stuns on every second hit as well. You know, a little mini stun to come out and amplify the damage up.
500 gold item where you can backtrack 300 damage.
Yeah, that'd be legit.
Everybody would be living.
Well, Tusk is the third pickup here for 99%. A little more mobility in their support role. Probably going to help out this time as they were kind of static in the previous game. But London Conspiracy, Lone Druid. Probably for Kefka towards the offlane. Got that Witch Doctor for Bivar as well. So we're still looking for the Baby Knight hero. There's still an OD out there. But against the Death Prophet, there are few and far between heroes that kind of face up nicely against her. You do need to rotate a few guys in to try and zone her out and stop her from getting a good start. But even so, we've seen Death Prophets come back from, you know, 0-4 in the laning stage to still having a 30-minute, you know, Yule Sept Octarine and a BKB or something like that. They're still very, very good at running into these team fights with just Exorcism and a couple of Crypt Swarms. That Soul Siphon, the Spirit Siphon, keeps her alive during the laning phase as well. So London Conspiracy, what are we looking at? No Broodmother, no Baby Knight mid-Brood, which has honestly been disgusting recently. They could have had the Brood Lycan combination, which they've loved to run of late. Well, that's a hard choice.
Well, I really love the Gyrocopter ban because Lone Druid offlane and then you get Witch Doctor Winter plus something. Wyvern. Okay, so this is what they're going to do. Dire so Winter Wyvern can back up the mid lane. And it can also help you out. See, the thing is, Winter Wyvern isn't that different from before. It's just his ulti, right? Normally, you want to pick it when there's an Invoker on the enemy team or even a Broodmother. Like, she can kill herself because of all the spiderlings and all the heroes. But in this game, there's not that many summons, so it's kind of weird to see it. But at the same time, it offers you a really strong early game situation where I think you can get away with killing the DP early on because of the Arctic Burn, because of the Splinter Blast, and then you also have the Cold Embrace to really help out in the mid lane. So I'm going to look forward to seeing where the Wyvern goes early on and seeing if he can get some good levels in which he needs to help out the mid lane. And then what other hero they're going to couple it with in the mid lane. Versus DP, I love seeing Lina's. Mostly Viper's decent. Radiant team
pick. Yeah, Lina's been super good recently with that Laguna Blade just thrown into DP because of her low HP pool. She does rely on kind of sustaining on like a third of her health with Spirit Siphon and things like that just to kind of draw the fight on. But we'll find out
what... Yeah, she outranges the DP just by a bit, and that helps out a lot in the laning phase. Obviously, if you run at the Lina with the Spirit Siphon, you just stun her away, and then you're pretty much good to go again. And the increased attack speed always helps out against the DP. And so,
offlane lifestealer. Here we go. Puck is
looking like it. It's looking like it. Okay. Okay, Puck. I think it's really weak against DP. And by that, I mean, one, if you use your orb, you can get put out of a position really quickly because Tusk is going to be roaming in the situation, right? So you have to be very cautious when you're using your orbs and how early you use them. Because if you use it, you're going to be getting snowballed upon early on. And then you also have the potential for the DP just to chase you down with the Spirit Siphon. So Puck, I don't like it in the situation with the one-on-one versus DP. But later in the game, I really love it against the Lifestealer. Because if he doesn't have a fast time and it looks like he's... Well, all right, I'm going to... take that back. He's just gonna be running around in ancient creep this game, so
it's gonna be nasty. Final hero for 99%. I'm pretty sure it's a safe laner. Juggernaut's the solid ban as always. Gyrocopter was taken out by 99% themselves. Something with maybe a bit of minus armor. Weaver wouldn't be too bad here, and that's what they're gonna go for.
Radiant.
I called it. Woo!
All right.
I mean, this hero is really great. Do you want to touch on it, or do you want me?
Weaver is a bug, and he has spells that do things. No, it's super good against the Lone Druid in lane, and also in the mid game. Just being able to swarm down the bear, focus the hero, do all sorts of nonsense like that. You can time lapse yourself away from Winter Wyvern and Lone Druid if they get too close up. But swarm plus exorcism. It puts these heroes in an awkward position where you have to kill off the bugs and take damage, or you have to just run the hell away. So a good way to bolster your armor is pick up a Sven with a Warcry and try and turn and fight up against it. So 99% right now, offlane Lifestealer, safe lane Weaver, and then kind of roaming supports with Lacoste and Grizzine on the Vengeance Tusk, and Death Prophet solo mid. I'm just looking at London Conspiracy and wondering what their plan is. Because 99% is like, we get DP items, we get Lifestealer items, we get Weaver items, and we just go and fight into towers. London Conspiracy seems a little more kind of focused on laning stage, and I guess it's going to be around the Spirit Bear, right? Get the Radiance on the Bear as quickly as you can.
Yeah, they have two greedy heroes in the Sven and Lone Druid that kind of need to have some resemblance of farm early on. Like, Sven, he can... We saw it last game where he can get the Helm of the Dominator and stack Ancients, but this game you might not be able to get away with it because of how 99% have drafted. They're just going to be constantly running at you. And then the Puck also needs to get a really good time blink because that is your initiation, as well as Yellowpy. He's going to need to get a fast time blink too, so you can really jump on these heroes and blow them up because Weaver, once he gets that Lincoln Sphere, it's going to be really hard to lock him down. Because one, you only have the silence to really get onto him, and then the stuns, it either has to be the Sven or the Winter Wyvern. So it's going to be very interesting to see if they're going to be able to burst him down. Obviously, we didn't touch upon the laning phase here. They could have gone aggressive. Okay, Mitch is... Wait, what? Okay, so... On the offlane Weaver? Okay.
Interesting. See, I thought they'd try and put the Weaver against the Lone Druid in the lane. To get the favorable matchup there, because Lone Druid's gonna piss off the Lifestealer, definitely. And if you want to roam
his
supports...
I don't think you can go aggro against a Witch Doctor Wyvern. But sacking your Weaver like this is... I don't think it's the play. I mean, I'm really confused right now. Maybe they thought London Conspiracy is gonna go aggressive, and they were gonna put the Lone Druid safe lane, but that's not the case right now, and...
Well, something 99% might have to adjust
to. Rosie, he already has sentries too, so Weaver has to go top. He just has to rotate.
You're right. Mitch is moving himself across. He's not hard committing to moving top, though. Looks like they'll try and find Kefka's lone druid over to the side, but Grizzine just get the sentry ward down to make sure that camp isn't farmed up by the lone druid, who can do it relatively efficiently off to the side. Are these lanes actually panning out the way they are? What did we get? Bounty rune apiece for each mid laner. Puck and DP both getting their hands on one of them. It's a very similar build up here. Puck has double fairy fire though. Well, the Death Prophet opted for a branch instead of that secondary fairy fire. As well as a salve actually being delivered out to him. So early days, early doors. There's the courier almost sniped out by the Winter Wyvern as this Death Prophet actually gets the Spirit Siphon and does a decent amount of damage. Good face shift. Dodge out from Baby Knight as well. And top lane, the Spirit Bear is about to die. Lacoste is going to kill the bear. Kefka loses his first summon. Oh, that's a big deal. Ventral Spirit gets herself 300 gold and experience from that.
Yeah, the experience has to be the bigger thing as well as getting the boots. Oh my, what a... At the end of the day, it's really good for the Lone Druid just because he's able to farm now. And he doesn't have to worry about dying, but feeding over that to the Roaming Venge, it could be very dangerous. And if that costs Baby Knight his life in mid lane, or even the top here, they can really follow him. Oh, okay.
Oh, they're going to kill Kefka here with the stun through after the open wounds. They've got the damage to do it. The Lone Druid, Duke as you may, you're not getting out of this situation without blood spilling. It's going to be his. So that's him resummoning Bear and then dying. So 80 seconds without your Lone Druid Spirit Bear. 99% off to a cracking start already as middle lane Baby Knight forced to fairy fire. He also has the phase shift available, and if those ice shards had connected or been a little bit longer range, Baby Knight could have found himself on the other side of the grave. At the very least, they do have bot lane going their way. Sven 8-5, while Mitch's Weaver still sitting at 1-0 in level 1.
Poor Kefka. I just feel so bad for him having to wait to do anything with his bear. And if he goes into the lane here, maybe he has eyes. He has eyes on the Venge? No.
Nope.
But now he will, once he goes down into the river. Still doesn't have any mana, no clarity out on the cost. He's already used it early on. Bottom lane, Yellowpea. Playing a little bit aggressive here. Doesn't have a Mango to work with. He could have had that. It seems it could have been a kill on Mitch there. Although he does have the Fairy Fire for the Weaver.
Mitch just salves himself back up to full. Try and bully the supports a little bit, but there's Obs plus Sentry here. Watching for the Weaver and his movements as mid Baby Knight. He's being bullied a little bit here by the Death Prophet, but he is winning in last hits. Baby Knight has 13-8. He's taken a pretty good stranglehold on this middle lane. So he got his bottle relatively faster than this Death Prophet did. Still 30 gold away from it, this DP. Kind of interesting to see her so far behind.
Yeah, I'm
top.
Really confused too. I've been just watching the top lane and the bottom. I haven't been paying attention to the mid lane matchup here, but DP losing this much to a Puck is kind of unheard of to me, but maybe it's just because the Winter Wyvern was helping out mid more than I really noticed. I was just watching the dives top, but...
Baby Knight is putting the damage down onto it's Death Prophet, but Grizzine with the Ice Shards there, trapping BBK in with a Spirit Siphon. It's good damage, but it's not the killing blow that they were really looking for to swing this lane back, and Baby Knight's the one straight back onto the aggressive. Looking for that orb damage, and maybe a smoke here from his supports. The Winter Wyvern and Witch Doctor, they're both over in this Radiant Jungle. Now just be to control this bottom rune. Keep it away from Mitch. Keep it away from this Weaver.
Top lane, here we go for the fight for the rune. Whoever gets this rune, ooh, fucked.
It's gonna be Baby Knight. It's gonna be BBK. And Winter Wyvern gets the bounty rune down at bottom lane as well. Oh, there's a snowball in under the tower, but Baby Knight, he just phase shifts it all the way. Everything's good with the world again. So Death Prophet forced to bottle crow already at this stage. It's a little bit rough for her. At the very least, they do have Ninja's Lifestealer farming way up at top, and this isn't the 4-roll lifestealer or the offlane lifestealer that we've been seeing recently. Oh dear. Ryu?
What?
Click on lifestealer.
I'm watching mid, baby.
Are people dying mid? Ah, they're fine. No, this is more important. Click
actually,
on.
He's dead.
Oh no, he's dead. Blink forward. They jumped with it. Oh, Baby Knight gets the kill. Another snowball dodge.
No,
he doesn't have phase shift and he's gone himself. Grizzine with a play, swings it back around. Now, more importantly, click on Lifestealer.
Okay.
Am I going insane?
No, you're not going insane. Is he going the Tranquil Boots still into Radiance?
Radiance top tower is under attack.
Why does he have brown boots and phase boots?
I just said it. That's the only reason. And because one, phase boots helps you a lot. Oh, yeah, you can get the kill on here on the bear. It's pretty nice to have here. And definitely worth it. Although it wasn't down.
Nearly dies. We'll find out. I guess he just sells them. He's gonna get two pairs of phase boots.
Oh, okay. No, so he's gonna I was about to lose my shit too.
He's going double phase boots. Oh my god. Oh, he nearly had me. No,
I think he meant to buy the gloves of haste, and he accidentally bought the boots.
Oh, the cost being sent back. The damage output's just too good from them. Finish him off. No, because he had brown boots, right? And he walked into side shop, and then he bought phase boots fully. I think the shop bugged out because I'm pretty sure he had brown boots and he walked in and he right-clicked phase boots and it bought the full thing instead of completing his brown boots he had. I don't know. Either way, he loses out on 200 gold. Not a massive deal. Not a massive deal, honestly. He's forcing this lone druid back a hell of a lot while Mitch is having a decent time down in bottom lane. Still no deaths. Like, fair enough, he's got no last hits either. But he's keeping himself alive and definitely forcing these supports to stay down here. Maybe looking for the kill onto Solon as they do get the snowball down. But look at the damage with the stun and the cleave. Yellowpea might be able to finish off Grizzine's Tusk here, but it's not quite enough. He has to war cry and chase him so deep that he's losing his life on top of this. A good 2-for-1 exchange there. Middle lane. Monty has got the overpowered sucky sucky spell onto that puck again. The Spirit Siphon is so annoying to handle, but he's being burnt down by Arctic Burn. And Biver's Winter Wyvern is forcing that DP back a fair amount.
If Baby Knight had his Dream Coil up, he would have probably went for the kill there. And Monty, they could still set up something. They have the supports here. They see them now. Okay, so this ward scouting out them on the top lane. Baby Knight won't play aggressive here. And it's going to be the 8-minute rune. We'll see where they want to test at. Maybe somebody wants to... Oh, they found out a rune here. Sentry ward is going down soon, too. That's very lucky to have.
Need to continue farming. Need to get that Helm of the Dominator up onto Sven. Start stacking up these Ancients. Well, they're actually already stacked up a couple of times. The supports have done a pretty good job keeping these camps flowing. How far are we from Putt Blink Dagger? Still a long, long distance, about 2 grand away. So getting herself up to that point. While Armlet on Ninja's Lifestealer is nearly done, and this is where Lifestealer really starts to come into his own. This is the early battle build with Armlet, Phase Boots. You just chase down the bear and you kill him over and over again. And against the Sven on top of that, the Sven has one stun, plus Warcry, plus God Strength. At this point, he doesn't really want to be farming. He doesn't want to be fighting. He wants to be farming as efficiently as he possibly can to get that boost of net worth. To kind of hop, skip, and jump him over the top of the Lifestealer. So if he's forced to fight, he's going to miss out on that. If he loses the fight, pushes the Lifestealer even further ahead. This is really key momentum time for 99% to make like aggressive pushes forward. Try and get into these tier 1s with Exorcism up now on the DP. But also to stop LC from farming. Because they have multiple heroes who require big key items. Blink Puck, Midas, and Radiant Saloon Druid. Winter Wyvern and the Witch Doctor, whatever. They don't require any big items. But just stopping Sven from farming Ancients is looking right now at Mitch. He's focusing down these supports. He's forcing the Witch Doctor. Oh, good shards. Blocks him in, but the dust back onto Mitch with the Dream Coil and stun. Have they got the damage and the silence? They get Mitch. Great rotations and reactions from London Conspiracy to get that one.
Mid lane, though, we have the DP pressuring. And at the same time, it was a nice rotation over, killing off the Weaver, but that's still giving a lot of space to the other lanes here. But Baby Knight's back. Doesn't have to fear the gank too much. Unless he gets... Okay. Now he does.
Is he going to get caught, though? There's no mana for a stun until now. The orb gives vision up onto the high ground, and they cancel the TP. Even with the ghosts flying around. Death Prophet picked out Weaver, Mitch. And what are you doing? You're level 6. You've just hit the time-lapse. Okay. There we go. He's fine. I was wondering what he's up to. He didn't have his ulti leveled, but he got the level 6 just in time. He should be fine.
Yep, it's, like you said, 99% have to put the pressure on right now. It's because they're... Well, he's killing the bear off top. It's just funny watching Ninja just prioritize hitting the bear instead of the actual hero. That's what you're meant to do when you have this feast up to level 3 here, but... At the end of the day, you're still not going to be killing Kefka, and he's only got 24 CS though, so still keeping him down. But Lone Druid is level 8 now, and is he going for his own armlet? What? Oh no, he's in phase boots.
Phase boots Midas. Looks like it for Kefka. Like the phase boots, you kind of need it against this lifestealer who, like you said, is just focusing down the bear every single freaking time.
Poison orb.
That's true.
It's definitely weird. I mean, you should have it at least for the other heroes on 99%. You want to slow down the DP, the Weaver as much as you can when he's out of Sekuchi, and it just deals a lot more DPS, even when you're farming.
Well, for now, not throwing the money at it. What's that Midas? What's that Midas pretty desperately? Smoke up here, looks like, from the Tusk and the Vengeful Spirit, right next to the Tier 2. Running themselves down into this Radiant Jungle, knowing that stacks are happening. The Wyvern and the Witch Doctor haven't made any big rotations, they've not smoked, they've not been playing aggressively. So what are they doing? What are they up to? They must be stacking for the Sven. And what way to catch them? And just run straight through into the jungle. Lacoste will scout out this camp, but the Winter Wyvern, Arctic Burns up into the trees, the vision, it's not quite there, they can't stun her up, and she's fine. Well, the snowball onto Yellowpea will only delay this movement forward. Mitch even has a lifestealer inside of him. I didn't notice that, but Infested is the lifestealer inside the Weaver. They TP up to top and they might find Kefka. There we go. Savage Roar forces them back. Lone Druid is hunky-dory. He's perfectly fine.
Is he going to pop out of here? This is a lot of wasted time for the lifestealer. This is not worth it. He needs to just pop out and farm, and they need to push top. Do you have his own TP? No? Ninja doesn't have his own. Mid lane, Death Ward, did a little bit of work, canceled there by the cost, and everybody just going to go skitter back to their own lane, their own side.
Dream Call, Death Ward kills off the Death Prophet. 5-5, 13 minutes in, and Sven, he got his Blink Dagger, he's got his helm, just needs to clear through more of these camps. They took out the Ancients, and he's managed to push himself up to top of net worth now, and this is where Sven really starts to excel. It is just completely flash farming people into oblivion. He's cleared up a bunch of these camps. Right now, you don't know what he's got, right? He's been off the map for so long. You know he's got something, but knowing whether he's gone for SNY, whether he's gone Blink, whether he's gone BKB, it's always going to be that surprise factor. So you have to kind of estimate and go worst case scenario. So 99% right now, they've got to say, okay, Sven probably has Blink, but they're trying to deal with the fight up at top. Spirit Siphon will slow Kefka down a little bit and kill off Solon. No magic stick charges until Shikuchi comes through and finishes him off. But the tier 1 tower was denied by the Lone Druid. And this entire time, the rest of London Conspiracy have just been farming themselves up to level 6 on the Winter Wyvern. Baby Knight, 100 gold away from his blink.
Okay, look at that. Lacoste just... Alright, GG.
He double warded the floor. That's a mistake.
That's 99% loss because of that.
1% victory chance when you place double wards in the wrong spot. Like, that's not even a warding spot, right? He meant to place them on top of the high ground, I'm sure.
Yes. Is under attack. I mean, look at this vision. I guess I could see somebody TPing in. That's at least better than nothing.
I mean, that wasn't meant to happen. That definitely wasn't meant to happen. Exorcism for a tier 1, but all of London Conspiracy are grouping up to fight this with a blink stun. Ninja's dead, and the Dream Call is down onto the Death Prophet as well. They've got the damage up from Yellowpea to clear him up. The Winter's Curse catches three of them on the back with a Death Ward down. Mitch is dropping low, but time lapses over to the side, but the rest of them Lacoste, all they need is an entangle, and you know what they get? They get a bloody entangle.
Nice silence, baby knight.
Looks like they'll clear up Grazine, and all of a sudden, from nothing, that's Sven Blink. Are they going to get a full team wipe here? Is Mitch dead as well? Shikuchi's ready now. He can get himself away a little bit further away. Baby Knight has the orb and the silence. They clear him up as well. It's a five-man team wipe here as LC come out of the woodwork with the Blink stun from Sven. 99% didn't have a flipping clue.
Yep. Sven just was not in a proper position there from the get-go to really nether swap anybody out. And then the good play coming in from Beaver, realizing that, hey, he's going to come up and swap, and then just curses them together. And like you said, they were really caught off guard by both of the blink daggers there and bursting down the enemy of the DP. And oh, poor Ninja. It would be really nice if they had a puck on their side for 99%, because the only thing they're really doing with the Lifestealer bomb in is the Weaver, and they did it once, it hasn't worked out, and the Lifestealer is not doing anything right now. He's just, it looks like he's becoming a burden, and it's giving a lot of space to Kefka to really catch up in this game, and it looks like he's going for the Maelstrom here, but they're putting pressure on the bottom lane here.
They're going to jump in. The snowball onto two. They've caught them. Yellowbee blinks forward aggressively. Baby Knight has the Dream Core, but he's silenced up by the DP. And Sven will TP out, and it will not actually complete. Sven was so close to escaping there while Baby Knight is dealing with the little bugs. He does face shift off the shards, but the DP gets the kill anyway. A couple of big streaks going the way of 99% as they turned that devastating loss. Some kind of minor victory. Meanwhile, back behind the tier 2 down at bottom lane, Mitch is forcing them all back. He even baited out the Death Ward.
Yep. 99% did a really good job there. Knowing that the enemy team had their ultis on cooldown, you just go pressure the bottom lane, and then London Conspiracy doing too much in that situation. Sven has 2.5k gold saved up, and he hasn't bought anything. He also didn't have his God Strength for that team fight, and they should have just cut their losses, and he shouldn't have blinked in. Giving your carry away at this stage of the game. Oh, I didn't even notice his last hits. 156. That is really impressive right now. He's been farming the Ancients. He's been farming everywhere. They stacked up in the jungle for him. Really nice job so far from Yellowpea this game. Besides
Baby Knight. Oh, the swap is there. Takes Mitch further away from the marauding Baby Knight Puck, who's just looking for kill after kill. Don't get anything from it just yet. Lone Druid, though, Kefka has kind of been left to his own devices for the past couple of minutes. He saved himself up a fair amount of money. He's actually gone... Oh, he didn't go for the Midas. He went for Facebook's Maelstrom on the Lone Druid Bear.
Yeah, and he might be going for a Vlad next. Or he might just get the... Bring a Basilius here just to help push a lot more faster, and it does add a lot of armor to your bear, which you desperately need against this Lifestealer, as well as the Venge plus Weaver minus armor combo. So it's not all that bad at the end of the day. Definitely rushing Vlad's, but still want to get that Mjolnir at a really good speed, because that'll help. It'll be about the same speed as Radiance. You just can't go for that split push play that you normally would like to go if you're a lone druid.
Oh, Baby Knight!
And way too aggressive here.
He's in a little bit of trouble here. The rest of the team trying to back themselves away. Viver does have that Winter's Curse, but the TP is out. Solon and Yellowpea were both complete. And where was the Yules? Death Prophet held onto it for a hell of a long time. With Savage Roar available on this lone druid,
Savage Roar,
he's perfectly fine. Roshan opens its doors. The 99% just to wander themselves in. Medallion on Mitch's Weaver. The cost treads and earn. It's Ninja Lifestealer though. Armlet Blink. Interesting item build up. The rest of London Conspiracy though, the ones that are alive at any rate, are running themselves towards this pit as quickly as they can. Because if they can get this combination play, they can Winter's Curse and set up for the fight, but they don't even need to. Yellowbee just blinks on in, kills off two straight off the bat. But there's the curse. Damage mitigated from the rest of the team. And Baby Knight says hello. Goodbye, Ninja. Okay, goodbye. Because there's nothing he can do. So that's Bivo went to Wyvern once he's healed himself up through the cold embrace, and that's a free Roshan for London Conspiracy on a silver platter.
That was not really well executed from 99% either. That was a huge play from Yellowpea, but they could have gotten Roche down before they came. One, you want to make sure that you don't have the life for the swarm, taking all the damage there, and they didn't have the feast onto Roche either, or the open wounds, I mean, so they couldn't really lifesteal back. And so he was forced to turn off his armlet, and they could have used the Venge stun earlier to pop the Roshan. So at the end of the day, they could have finished off Roche, but still, that could have been the same outcome.
I like this Dagon pickup on Baby Knight. Now, we talked about the leaner against Death Prophet and just having that kind of raw aggression, the naked burst damage straight onto DP. Having the Dagon on Puck, Baby Knight could definitely kind of play that role, even against a Lifestealer or a Weaver. You know, Lifestealer before his Rage is relatively susceptible just to that magic burst damage if they can pull it off and bring him low so the Sven can just cleave on through him. This Puck is going to be a slippery little devil with a shotgun to play with. At this point, London Conspiracy, they're the ones in the driving seat with a Basher now done for Kefka's lone Druid. Even more control and lockdown that they can actually throw into these teamfights.
I'm just really worried for Baby Knight if he gets silenced. Then he's pretty much dead. Swap into silence or swap into stun of some sort and he's dead. Normally you want to see the Yules coming out, but I agree with you. I really love Dagon. And the only heroes I can think you can get away with it is Puck and Tinker. So in this situation, we'll have to see if it helps burst down these heroes. And Yellowpea plus Ninja, what happens?
Oh, they both run away. they both run away from each other. Oh, that was kind of amusing. They were trying to aim for the Lone Druid wraparound, I think. But the fact Sven was there kind of indicated to 99%, but the rest of them were all hanging around. Orb forward with a double silence and a dream coil. Baby Knight catches two of them, and this Death Prophet just getting zapped down. The Dagon's out, and the God Strength is there. Lacoste is going to get slammed into the ground as well by Yellowpea as he just moves from target to target, bringing down one after the other after the other. And Mitch, oh, Mitch, you are in a ton of pain. Slight chance of survival. Survival chances. Dropping, raising,
increasing.
Mitch, raising, is he escaping? Is he actually running away from this? He's got another Shikuchi, but he's bashed up by the bear! They don't finish him quite just yet, he's escaping on a slither of health, he's gonna get himself a little bit further away, but there's Sven, blink, Dagon, zap, dead, gone, got him.
That was a lot of space though, and he's up in 35 seconds, he also has buyback here, so if they did go high ground, that was really well played from 99%, creating a lot of space there. They have Dream Coil back up in 20. Aegis is still online for the next 2 minutes. They don't have Godstrength. Going uphill doesn't seem
viable.
I guess maybe though. Oh, he's getting bottle nice.
Oh, there we go.
All right, we're good.
Lone Druid Bear up there with a Demolish onto that tier 3. There is a Glyph here for 99%. This high ground push might be the undoing of London Conspiracy, but with the War Cry and the Cold Embrace, they're keeping everyone pretty tanky and healed up. The Lifestealer attempted to jump on in, but there's the Savage Roar pushing them back. Yellowpea turns to kill off Mitch. The damage output not quite good enough with Lacoste. The swap back saves him up, and the Lone Druid Bear does die. As London Conspiracy bail themselves a little bit further back, and the TP out from Puck will indicate their retreat is full on. Exorcism is actually used up here by the DP. Solon gives his life for the greater good. Sacrificial lamb, just get the hell out of here, guys.
Yeah, don't kill my bear, boys.
Threw himself onto the hand grenade.
Yep, that was dead man's play. Oh, Ninja, though, with this well-timed blink dagger, he needs to catch it. Rage? Okay.
The Lone Druid actually turns to fight this.
Rip.
And tangle up. Lone Druid is fine. He can bring the Spirit Bear back. Kefka, not taking enough damage until the blink forward aggressively again will catch him. Tusk dies to the Puck onto the side, and they're actually looking for more. Yellowpea, the damage output, the Aegis is gone, but Baby Knight's dead as well. 99% might be able to jump back on into this Sven's hunting for the little lifestealer. He sees him. He has no mana either. Cannot armor toggle through the DPS of God Strength. Interesting trade-offs here and there. But 99% probably feel a little happier with this. Just the fact they killed Lone Druid, they killed Puck. And the push isn't going to come for another 30 seconds.
Yeah, they've weathered the storm here. They're creating enough space for their DP to get bigger. She's up to 3k gold. She needs to have a BKB in this situation. Normally you want to see Octarine Core, but she's getting bursted down. She doesn't have free reign in these team fights, and she just needs to have one. And then you can go for, I think, Shiva's Guard. This is the one game where you don't really want to go Octarine Core, because you need to have the armor for the Death Ward, the Sven, the Lone Druid, and then you also need to have the BKB so you're able to survive. So I'm a really big advocate of the Octarine, but just not this game.
Well, we'll find out what it goes for. Fucking Monty. 3,200 gold saved up. What a conspiracy.
Got another fucking man.
Yeah. LC just reset. AC is done on Yellopy there. The Sven. Tons of armor to handle up against those Death Prophet ghost ladies flying around and flapping their wings. 99% just kind of struggling to regain control of their own jungle. This Lifestealer, who is doing well farm rate wise, has slipped. He's now sitting below the DP. He's actually just over half of the net worth of the Sven, which is kind of insane.
It's just his attack speed is, well, not his attack speed. He lacks attack speed. He lacks a lot of mobility, right? He still has the phase boots plus the blink dagger, but he still doesn't have a Sage and Yasha to really chase down the targets. Obviously, he's casted his open wounds, and then he doesn't cast his rage off, and then the bear just savage roars him back. So you want to blink in rage and then cast open wounds. So he's been doing the spell cast in the wrong order. He also doesn't have... wonder what he's going to go for next. Maybe it's a Desolator, but yeah, his item regression right now is just really lackluster, and he needs a lot of armor. They also need an AC on their team. So
they need everything. Just open the shop and just say, give it all to us, please.
Please.
Start giving Dagons to the towers or something, because Ninja, oh my goodness, that Yellopy Sven just jumps him. Jumps his bones and says goodnight. The little Lifestealer Ghoul Man is gone, while the Lone Druid demolishes this tower pretty simply. There's a glyph up for 99%, but the buyback from Lifestealer is the one that we have to kind of pay attention to, because Weaver gets obliterated as he jumps forward again onto a target, and now DP pops the ghosts, gets Yellopy trapped under the Spirit Siphon, but it's baby night. Dream calls through, Death Ward down, Lacoste is gone. They need to focus his Death Prophet, though her damage output is pretty damn good. Ninja, oh, Winter's Curse, not enough, jumps into a creep, jumps out again, does a little hokey pokey, dance himself around, but it's Monty. Monty the DP, he gets himself healed up, but it's not enough. Yellowpy is just slamming through them all, one after the other, while the Spirit Bear's on cleanup duty. Grizzine gonna happily walk himself away from this until Baby Knight rejoins. DD Rune is up. Is Baby Knight dead to the little swarm bug? He is indeed. But Beaver gets the counter kill onto the Weaver with a snowball through. Lone Druid will take this kill with ease. And now maybe even the full lane of Rax.
We're going to get a fight back here. Radiant's bottom tower, as well as the Venge coming back online. He has a resummon. There we go. It's just not enough. Have to back out, but that was still two buybacks used on the Lifesteal and the Weaver, and the item progression of 99% is just not coming right now. And this Lifestealer once was top net worth of the game, and or second at least to the Sven, and just hasn't been doing too much. It's really hard to keep up with your farm. You have Cleave, and you don't have like a Maelstrom on the Weaver or on the Lifestealer. It just looks so much over. Just because of the Lifestealer doesn't have the item progression, but they still have the DP ulti coming online. The Weaver just seems like a walking Crypt Swarm at this moment. He's putting Medallion on people just to help with the armor. It's all on the DP. She had a really nice silence during that team fight on 4 or 5 heroes. It just wasn't enough.
Tough stuff. Tough stuff for them. And Mitch is scrambling to get himself towards a Lincoln Sphere or something. Because this Sven with the Dream Coil, with the stuns coming out of him, it's just so easy for LC to set up on a couple of targets, and Roshan is their target right now. Don't need to expend any abilities, just give themselves vision across. Make sure there's no contest here from 99%. Once again, they're going to be too late. They've smoked themselves up and run down the mid lane. I think they were looking for tier 1 mid, or I don't know. But they're going to walk straight on into London Conspiracy Ninja. He's in a very forward position up on the high ground. Beaver, four staff up. Winter's Curse is down. He's got it. Landed it onto Ninja. And this will allow them to regroup and try and get the blink on in. Illusory Orb. No, he's stunned up. The silence is late. The Dream Coil. Maybe now we'll be able to hold him in place, but they've already lost one. The four-man coil. But Yellowpea cannot get in there onto a target. It's the blink. He blinks. He gets the slam. The two-hit kill. Down onto the DP and the Weaver, and 99% tap out. GG, well played. LC take it 2-0.
What an Abyssal Blade coming in from Kefka too. I mean, this is just really simple execution from London Conspiracy, making 99% buyback. Lifestealer became useless. Weaver was, like I said, just a walking armor like debuffer. And then it was just too much on the backs of Bucking Monty there towards the end. Their lineup had so much potential. It's just that they kept getting picked off. And that one team fight mid where they just got completely caught off guard by the two blink daggers of London Conspiracy really throttled them into a really good position, because they shut down the lone druid before then. He had completely nothing, just like phase boots on him. And then, yeah, lone druid is useless in this game. That could have been just pretty much the end of it. But nope, London Conspiracy, really well played there in the mid game. And then transitioning into late game, we saw how useful Beaver's Winter Wyvern ultis were, just making them all clump up. And then Yellowpea, really patient, just blinking in always afterwards and cleaning them up.
Well, that's it for tonight, guys. Dota Pit is done for today. If you do still have some cravings for Dota 2, though, head over to ESL_joinDotaRed, where Toby and Heen are casting the ESL Manila qualifiers throughout the night, I believe, as there's the endings of Stark against Hellraisers, best of three right now, and there should be a best of three coming up straight after that one. On top of that, with WePlay continuing tonight at 11 p.m. CET, check out twitch.tv/joindotared without the ESL in front for Dragon Drop casting some NA Dota over there. So there's lots of Dota happening. It's all here on Join Dota. So thanks, Ryu, for joining me. Thanks, guys, for watching and tuning in. We'll be back tomorrow with more Dota 2. I don't think Dota Pit starts again on Wednesday. There's no scheduled games for tomorrow. But there's WePlay all day on Monday. So make sure you check that out. So good night. Thanks for watching. See you guys next time.